Well, today is not going to be a regularly scheduled vlog because I wanted to do a video specifically about an update to a video that I did a few weeks ago or a month ago. Whatever, let's just get right into it. So I recorded a video about a month ago or so, or maybe a little bit longer, about my entire import and storage workflow for my company and what I do in video production. And since that video, a lot has changed. And since I've started to get a lot of views on that specific video and a lot of questions about it and asking about different things, I figured I'd do kind of an update video on that because even though most of the storage workflow is the same, there's a very vital part, the offline workflow, that has changed a lot, that has dramatically helped just really keep things organized and safe. So I wanted to kind of do an update video so that instead of answering the same question over and over on that channel and on that specific channel or that video, it would just be an update here. So let me tell you a little bit about how I do my overall import workflow, storage, backup, that whole thing for my work that I do in video production. So sorry first off if this is like a weird setup, it's just easiest to show you on the whiteboard, then I can kind of feel like a teacher, but I'm not a teacher at all. But anyway, I wanted to tell you a little bit about my workflow. My workflow is actually pretty simple as far as my storage workflow, but there are a lot of pieces to it that make a lot of sense. And so that's what I kind of wanted to clear up of why I have certain drives doing certain things and where I go from one step to the next and all that. So I basically have four main pieces of my whole overall storage workflow, and they are this. I have a Drobo, which is 20 terabyte RAID. I then have a G drive, which is 4 terabytes, USB 3, 7200 RPM. Used to be considered a really fast drive, now it's like slow in comparison. Then I have another G drive, same exact drive. Then I have a really fast SSD that is 1 terabyte, USB-C or USB 3. Then I have a master storage online and off-site Google Drive, and this is unlimited storage. And that is on the internet off-site. Sorry, I have terrible handwriting. So this may seem right away very confusing, but basically I have these, and I say four things because these are actually combined, but I'll explain that in a second. Four main things: RAID storage, two identical mirror drives, a very fast editing drive, and then an offsite complete backup drive. So let me explain how this whole process works. So the Drobo is the main storage facility for every single file of every project that I do. It's the main untouched raw files that come in from a project. So as soon as I arrive home from a wedding, from a commercial shoot, whatever it is, the very first place I import to is the Drobo. I rename all the files and I put them on the Drobo. So let's just say this is raw untouched masters. So that's all the raw files. They all get put there immediately. Then I create a Final Cut project or Premiere Pro project, depending on what I'm using for the project. And I bring it all onto the G drive. So I take all the files and I import them into an actual Final Cut Pro project or Premiere project onto the G drive. This drive is needs to be edited. So I bring any project that needs to be edited into a library file, project, Final Cut file, Premiere project. So let's just say I name that as an example, Tom and Jen, 8/21/17, whatever. I name it the title and the date of whatever the actual project is, and it is ready to be edited. So this is always either an FCP10 library file, Premiere Pro file, needs to be edited. And it's in its form that is ready to be edited. So files are in there, they're transcoded, whatever they are, they're ready to go. Whenever I'm ready for them, they're ready to go. This drive is just a mirror backup of this drive. So this drive's only function is to back up the other G drive. I use a program called ChronoSync that mirrors those drives. So this drive every day just backs up that drive identically. So this is just full of anything that is currently in fulfillment that needs to be edited. once a project is actually going to be edited. So these need to be edited. And then I have what's called my SSD, the fastest drive that I own, that are basically the projects that actually need to be edited. So not just needs to be, but they're ready to be. I am ready to get on the editing process of them. I take the file from the G drive and I bring it onto the SSD. So then Tom and Jen, for example, 8/21/17, now lives on the SSD. When it lives on the SSD, it gets removed from the other drive. The reason it gets removed is because it's easy for me to know that this right here, this Tom and Jen 8/21, is the recent, most recent being edited project, and I know that it's only here, and if I ever have anything go bad, I lose something, files, whatever, I can get them from the master. But then I'm never confused with whether this is the recent or this is the recent or wherever it is. There's always only one being edited file that's on top of there. Now, every single night between midnight and 6 a.m., my computer automatically backs up the SSD, 1 terabyte, to the Drobo. So there's a backup every night happening on there. So Tom and Jen is being edited. I'm working all hard on it all day. I'm doing edits. Everything's looking great. I leave my computer overnight. It backs it up, so it's always on there. So now on the Drobo, at all times, I have basically the raw untouched files, the audio, video, all the masters, and I also have the currently being edited project, which is very important, so I never lose anything, which is great. Then once a project is entirely done, the project has been sent to the couple or the client, whatever it is, it's done, everything looks great, I basically delete all the generated files, so render files, proxy files, whatever it is, I delete all the stuff from there, and I take this master folder, I copy that master folder to the Drobo and replace the master file. This now becomes the master because it's now all the original files, it's the edited files, everything's ready to go. That becomes the master on top of the Drobo. So at any given point, years down the road, I can go and access Tom and Janet. It has the Final Cut file, whatever it is, the actual edits, I can re-edit things, whatever, and all the files for the actual thing are inside there. So I can instantly always access them and go back. Now the piece that wasn't covered in the previous video because I didn't used to do it, but now I do, is I have extremely fast internet. I have about 900 megabits per second upload and download Verizon Fios. The reason I say that is because this is extremely important if you want any sort of offline workflow. If you do not have extremely fast internet, this whole process of an off-site Google Drive type of storage literally is impossible because this just takes way too long if you don't have fast internet. A typical wedding is usually 400 to 600, 700 gigs per wedding, and that's every single week, and anytime I do projects in the middle, it's between then. So if you don't have extremely fast internet, you cannot back something up quickly to this. Now the important thing about the Google Drive is that it is not backup. Unlike an online backup where it's just backing up a certain drive, this is literally like having another external hard drive offsite. So this has files that I can instantly access, I can upload specific things to it, I can just take a certain file from a project entirely from the Google Drive. And because I have a business account, this is unlimited. So currently on my Google Drive, I have 16 terabytes of footage. It's unlimited storage, truly unlimited storage, which is huge because I utilize a lot of it. On the Google Drive, I have this raw, untouched masters project. So the minute I import everything to the Drobo, from the minute I do it when I get home, once everything is into this, immediately I take that file, I drag that entire folder that has all the stuff into it immediately on the Google Drive, and it lives there. So that way, in the worst case scenario that my Drobo fails and I lose everything on the Drobo and everything on the SSD because it's backing that up, everything also lives on the Google Drive. Now the great thing about the Google Drive is that because it is truly unlimited, I can keep these on here forever. So I have every project now from 2014, 15, 16, and 17 on there. So if I ever need to bring a project back, no matter how old it is, I can simply download the entire project file, 300, 400, 500, 600 gigs. Because I have very fast internet, I can do that in about an hour. I can upload about 500 gigs in about an hour and a half onto this server, which is fantastic. This is something I never did previously because the internet was too slow. Now that it is super fast, it's incredibly convenient, and it's an awesome peace of mind because I truly can know that if all my drives failed, or more importantly, if something catastrophic happened like a fire or a flood, whatever it was, that's everything in my office, I still wouldn't lose all the masters, which is huge for me. Because at any given point, as you can see, I have 4 backups of stuff going on. So I'm really, really safe when it comes to hard drives. But if everything in the same location fails, well, then I'm kind of screwed. So that is where the Google Drive comes in and gives me a huge peace of mind for all that. And then once a project is entirely completed and I copy that new master onto the Drobo to replace the old master, I also copy that entire new thing onto Google Drive. So the Google Drive keeps everything. On the Drobo, I keep 1 year worth of stuff. So it could be about 15 terabytes-ish after a year, but on the Google Drive, I keep everything. So that way I can quickly locally download anything I need from past projects if I need something, but then anything past a year, I can go to the Google Drive and actually access it. So that may seem like a bit overkill to you if you're a person that's literally running off one drive. You may say, I've never had a hard drive failure, that's just overkill. I have a whole RAID system, I have 2 additional backups, and then I have another one that I'm actually editing off of, and then all those are being backed up by Google Drive. It does seem like overkill, I get it. But I'm a person that believes that, number one, right now storage is fairly cheap. And more importantly, with weddings, it's really, really risky to not have things backed up a lot of times, because a wedding you don't get another chance at. If worst case scenario, I lost some sort of client video for, let's say, some sort of commercial, worst case scenario, I can go shoot that again and I can say, I really apologize, this just didn't work out. Unfortunately, I lost every single thing and I have to reshoot this. And they might not be happy, but we can reshoot it. You don't get any other chance at a wedding. So when it comes to a wedding, I take absolutely zero chances, and I'd rather have way too many overkill of basically 5 backups of everything at one time and be completely okay with knowing that I'm 100% safe in that. But that's just me. But from a level at the computer standpoint, I basically have a project folder that I have a template based on, that every single project that comes into the computer is built on a folder template, so that it's very easy for me to know what that is. So let me walk you quickly through what that template is, just to keep everything organized every single time. So from a computer standpoint, you can see here on my drives, I have a Drobo, I have an SSD, I have 2 G drives, and then a Time Machine backup. So if I open up the Drobo, you can see by years, and only this year I keep, so 1 year at a time. 2017 weddings, you can see there's all the weddings. Here's the commercial work. Here's some other work. You can see it's all in a folder structure. And basically the folder structure is really simple. This right here is basically my template master folder. I basically copy this master folder template into the Drobo, and then I name it accordingly. So as you see, I have names here and their date of when the actual wedding was. And inside that master folder template, here's what I have. And some of these I don't use on every project basis. I just have it in there as a template just in case. A lot of these I use for commercial, but I don't necessarily use for weddings and vice versa. So I have a documents folder. Inside the documents folder, I have things for graphics, like Photoshop documents, whatever. I have a miscellaneous folder that can be random things. I have stills folder if I get graphics or additional things from, let's say, a client or their graphic designer or whatever. I then have an exports folder, which is rough cut sent to client, final deliverables. That's where I keep, obviously, all my final deliverables, so that when it's on the Drobo and when it's on Google Drive, it's easy for me to remember what those are. I have a files from editor folder. This is more for Google Drive than anything. When I give an editor access to one of these folders on Google Drive, they are able to throw in additional files that they may have added that I don't have on my original projects, like music or files, whatever it is. Then I have a media original folder. Inside that, I have audio, which is music, recordings, like the external recorders. I have a sound effects folder that has all sound effects. Then I have a voiceovers folder. Then I have video footage. And inside that video footage folder is where I keep all the master video footage. And that's where I keep everything. That's how I keep it very organized and know that's the master. and I have project files for editing, and I have an Adobe Premiere folder, which would be all my Adobe Premiere project files, backup files, everything that Adobe Premiere automatically creates. Then if I'm using Final Cut for that project instead, I would then have the Final Cut library inside this instead. So then every single wedding, every single project, whatever it is, keeps that same structure. So when I go to years here and I go to wedding and I choose one of the recent weddings, you'll see that that structure is the same. And then inside video footage, you'll now see there's all the footage from the wedding. And inside audio, you'll see that there's the recordings, the ceremony groom, the DJ taps, all that stuff. You'll see inside exports. Right now, there's nothing in final deliveries because this is actually something that I'm currently editing. Then if I go to the 4LC Studios drive, you can see that here are the projects that are currently needing to be edited. So I have a couple weddings here. I have a commercial job. And then these are two projects that my other editor is doing. And this is just some DJI footage. But then you could see on the SSD, the only project that I'm currently working on is this wedding and then this SDS design, which is just another company that we're working for. So basically that's how it's laid out, very simply. And then once I'd be done with this project on the SSD, I would take this folder, I'd hit copy, I would bring it to the Drobo, I would go into the years, I would choose that specific wedding, I'd replace everything and make that the new master. And that's how it's set up. And then this is what my Google Drive looks like. So basically you can see that I have all previous years here. If I go to a specific year and go to weddings, you could see all the weddings from previous years. This is everything. So this is all their footage. This is Final Cut Pro bundle files, library files. You can see that if I go to 2017, I have all the weddings again in there, and I have additional weddings that aren't even on the other drive. Basically all masters. So I have everything in there, all the original media, everything's in there. Organized, it's all in there. It has tons of backups and it's just super nice and convenient to have. And it's nice because if a couple were to contact me from, let's just say, 2016 and they suddenly needed an additional ceremony or they lost footage or whatever it is, I can simply go to that project no matter how old it is. Go to completed films, I can just see all their films that were done. I can download them in a second, I can re-upload them, I can send them. Just super easy, super organized, and that's what I'm all about. So that's basically it. I hope this was somewhat helpful to you to see how I do things. I will do another whole like import process and show you how I rename files. You can check back in that other video that I did a couple months back about this process where I went into a little bit about how I actually name files and put things in. But this, I just wanted to do an update video because I think it's important to see that the offsite backup that I added as part of my overall workflow is extremely important because it gives me an additional offsite safe backup. But that's how I do it. I have lots of backups, lots of drives, lots of files, but it's extremely organized. Even though it may seem crazy and like a bit overkill, I can tell you exactly where files are, and my other editors who work with me know exactly how that system is set up as well, so they stay very organized in it, and it just makes it easy. If someone needs to get a file, they know where to look, they know where the most recent one is, they know where the masters are, they know where things are, and it's just important to do the same process every time. Every time I get done with a wedding, a client, commercial, whatever it is, I immediately do that process. First things first, take everything off the SD cards, and I format the SD cards because then I know that everything is safe and good to go. So I think it's important to just get in a process, regardless what your process is, do it the same way every single time, then you know that you're safe. Hopefully this was helpful. If you have any questions at all, comment below. I will be glad to answer them. That's what this channel is all about. If this is your first time here, I appreciate you watching this. Consider subscribing. I post lots of videos and daily vlogs every single day. So that's it. Thanks for watching. For those that regularly watch the vlogs, tomorrow's a wedding. Behind the scenes coming. See ya.